Today we are going to start with the unit excretory system. In this unit, we will going to discuss about the excretory organ, which is a pair of a kidney. Okay, today we are going to start with the unit excretory system. In this unit, we will going to discuss about the excretory organ, which is a pair of a kidney. And later on, we will going to discuss about the secondary excretory organs like our skin. Okay, in skin, we have oil glands, we have sweat glands. And then we will going to discuss about the secondary organs like large intestine, your liver, etc. Okay. First, we are going to talk about the basic, why there is a requirement of a kidney. Okay, so kidney is responsible for the excretion. Okay, first you should know what is the difference between in excretion and ejection. There are two terminology which you must be familiar about it. The one is your excretion and the second one is your ejection. Excretion is removal of nitrogenous metabolic waste throughout your body. And ejection is what? Ejection is removal of undigested food through your GIT system. Okay. See, whatever the food is absorbed in your body during the process of digestion, this food is going to be utilized by your cell. Now your cells are generating the waste, and this waste is known as the metabolic waste. Okay, and the undigested food, it doesn't become the part of the cell respiration. Okay, it just remove out the body through the alimentary canal. Okay, so what is excretion? Excretion is removal of nitrogenous metabolic waste. When this metabolic waste is generated in your body during the time of metabolism, okay, during the time of metabolism. Now there is another term, which is osmoregulation. In this earth, every living organism required to maintain this osmoregulation. Osmoregulation is what? To maintain the water and ionic content of the body. Okay, so what is osmoregulation? Osmoregulation is a maintenance of, ionic and salt content, and water level of body. Clear? So this osmoregulation and the process of excretion is done by the pair of your excretory organ, that is your kidney. Kidney is responsible for the process of excretion and the process of osmoregulation, means it maintains the osmolarity, it maintains the water and ionic salt level in our body. Clear? Like your unicellular organism, which is amoeba. Amoeba also maintain their osmoregulation because they have to survive, na? See, there are two types of excretory organs. The primary, which is very important, that is your kidney, and the secondary excretory organ, as we were discussed, these are your livers, large intestine. In skin, we have sebaceous glands, okay, the sweat gland, the sudoferous glands, etc. Now we are going to talk about the main metabolic waste. How this metabolic waste is generated? So there are three types of metabolic waste. The one is your carbohydrate, fats, proteins and fats. Okay, so on the metabolism of carbohydrate, because these are the three components which we intake maximum, yes, so during the time of metabolism of carbohydrate, there is a generation of waste like CO2 and water. Okay, and the fats on the metabolism, this produce what? CO2 and water. And the protein and fats on metabolism of this, your nitrogenous waste produce like your urea and all. See, your lungs also play a very important role in excretion. you must be know about it. Per day 400 ml per day from your lungs, 400 ml water lost by the lungs. Okay, because excessive water is not good for your body, because it increase the concentration of the protons. Okay, the next is the main metabolic waste in human body. The first, you know, that CO2, water. So see, in human body, these metabolic waste are removed as follows. So CO2, how we removed it during the breathing, is exhaled out, and it also converted into the urea and bicarbonate ions. Okay, the next is water. How water is removed from our body? Water is removed in the form of urine, yes, sweat, okay, sweat glands we have, through the lungs. As I told you, from our lungs, per day 400 ml of water is lost, okay, in the form of moisture that we exhaled out. When you exhaling the air, so during the time of exhalation, some moisture come out, and this moisture contains the water vapors, clear? Now, there are three type of main nitrogenous waste. The one is ammonia, the second one is urea, and the third one is uric acid. Okay, if I talk about a human, because in this we are going to talk about the human excretory organ, so our main metabolic waste is urea. Okay, so that's why we are what we are, the ureotelic organism, clear? But not all the organism have this waste, na? Some have different waste, some have another waste. So the type of excretory waste, first, it depends on the habitat, and the second is depend on the complexity of a body, clear? And according to that, we divided into the three categories: ammonia, urea, and uric acid. In our body, there is a uric acid too, which is converted into the metabolic waste, and we also have a ammonia. But these not are our main metabolic waste. Our main metabolic waste is only urea. Clear? Now, the next, if I talk about the which one is more toxic in amongst the nitrogenous waste, ammonia is a most toxic type of a nitrogenous waste. Clear? So ammonia is first point about the ammonia. Ammonia, it is highly soluble in water. So definitely it requires a large amount of water. Which organism afford this large amount of water? Those who have a habitat in water only. We can't afford this much water, yes or no? That's why this is not our main metabolic waste. So ammonia is very toxic, and ammonia, if it is come in contact with any organ, it can damage that organ. That's why it is highly toxic. So process of excreting ammonia, this is known as ammonotelism, and large amount of water is required for it removal, because it is highly soluble in water. It is formed by the deamination of amino acid. It is removed as the ammonium ion through the body surface with the help of a simple diffusion, or through the gill surface. Okay, organism with ammonia as a excretory waste, they are known as ammonotelic organism. For example, the frog larva, the tadpole is ammonotelic organism. The second is bony fish, and mostly invertebrates. Invertebrates like your Coelenterata, your Ctenophora, Porifera, their main excretory waste is ammonia. Clear? The next is urea. The process of excreting urea is ureotelism. Okay, so we have this process, which is your ureotelism. And if I compare the toxicity of ammonia with the urea, so urea as comparison to ammonia, it is 1 lakh time less toxic, okay? For the removal of urea, it also require water, but not as comparison to the ammonia, because they have a least toxicity. It requires less water for its elimination, and urea where it is produced. So urea produced in our liver, and for that a particular cycle is going on, which is ornithine cycle. Okay, ornithine cycle, or also known as the Krebs-Henslet cycle. Next, where the urea is found, in our blood, and some amount of urea found in the kidney matrix. Okay, in kidney some amount of urea is also stored to maintain the osmoregularity. Okay, in kidney matrix there's a storage of urea. the storage of urea. Why? To maintain the osmolarity. The next, the urea, it is excreted by what? It is excreted by the kidney. How urea is formed? By the reaction of your CO2 and water. CO2 and water, when they react, they form the excretory waste, that is your urea. Okay, urea is formed where? Urea is formed in liver, okay? And from the blood, it goes into the kidney where the excretion of this urea take place, okay? Because kidney have a structural and functional unit which is known as uriniferous tubule, and also you call them as a nephron, okay? Nephron is the one which is responsible for the filtration of blood. So since liver produce the urea, now this urea travel in the blood. Now blood take this urea and passes to the kidney, so that blood is going to be filtered out, because as I end we know that urea is toxic. Now in kidney filtration it take place, and now in the form of urine, with the help of the process maturation, we will pass the urea. Maximum urea in human body, where it is found? It is found in hepatic vein. Hepatic word we are uses for liver, so it is found in the liver vein. And minimum urea is found in the renal vein. Renal word we are using for the kidney. Clear? Ureotelic organism, mammals, humans, yes, frog, toad, cartilaginous, fishes. The next is uric acid. Uric acid requires negligible amount of water for its elimination, because it is least toxic, okay? Their toxicity is very least. It is least toxic. Those organisms who have main excretory waste, this uric acid, they generally excreted their waste in the form of paste or in the form of pellets, okay? Because it requires very low amount of water. So it excreted in solid form as a pellets, and the process of excreting uric acid is known as uricotelism. How uric acid is formed? Uric acid is formed during the metabolism of nitrogenous bases, okay? It is formed from the purines like adenine and guanine, okay? You know that nitrogenous bases, what we have? We have purines and pyrimidines. Purines example are your adenine and guanine. Pyrimidine example are your cytosine, uracil and thymidine. So during the metabolism of adenine and guanine, there is a formation of uric acid. And one more thing I want to share with you. If there is excessive amount of accumulation of uric acid in a body, so this uric acid crystal, they erode the cartilage of joints, okay? And they cause a arthritis in a human being. And this disease is known as gout, okay? Gout, how it is happening? Because of the accumulation of uric acid, and it causes the erode in the articular cartilage, okay? A gout, like an inflammation in joints. Uricotelic organism, reptiles, bird, land snake, insects like your cockroach, okay? The next one more thing, if you notice, those organism whose main excretory waste is uric acid, they are generally oviparous. What are oviparous? Oviparous are those who lay egg, okay? So they have a cladoid type egg. They have a cladoid type of a egg. So their main excretory waste is always uric acid, because inside this egg there is a development of the embryo. If embryo release the waste like ammonia, so ammonia damage the early embryo, okay? That's why their waste is uric acid, and this thing was discovered by the scientist Joseph Nathan, okay? They say that according to the reproduction, the type of waste is also depend, because if they have ammonia, so ammonia can damage the early embryo. Urea require a water, yes or no? So the best suitable excretory waste is uric acid, because uric acid does not harm the development of early embryo. Clear? The next, we have this excretory organ. As I told you, in primary we have one pair of kidney along with other excretory structures, yeah, like your ureter, urinary bladder, okay? Secondary skin, in the skin we have sweat glands, we have oil glands, liver, lung, large intestine and salivary glands. In the last, we will discuss about the secondary organ. First, we are going to start with the kidney. So this is a basic structure of a kidney. As you see here, this is our right side of our kidney and this is our left side of our kidney. Why I'm saying this is right and this is left? If you see, there's a difference in position of kidney. Why? Because see, right side of kidney, it is little downward as comparison to the left one. Because right on the right side, there's a presence of liver this side. Okay, there's a presence of what? There's a presence of liver this side. Because of the presence of liver, it is down. Because of the presence of liver, it is little bit downward. Okay, we have one pair of a kidney. This is kidney. If I talk about the shape of a kidney, so as you see, the kidney shape is bean shaped. Okay, and what are the dimension of kidney? You just have to remember 10 5 2.5, 10 centimeter, 5 centimeter and 2.5 centimeter. 10 centimeter is length of kidney, 5 cm is width of kidney, 2.5 cm is thickness of the kidney. Clear? Now you got it? Why the right side is little downward? Because here the presence of liver. And at the top of a kidney, you can see here a cortical-like structure. This is what? This is the adrenal gland. This is what? This is the adrenal gland. And adrenal gland secretes hormones like catecholamines, adrenaline, noradrenaline, yes or no, glucocorticoids hormones secreted by this adrenal glands. Yes, now you can see here a pair of a ureter. This ureter carries urine. Okay, once the blood is filtered in your kidney, then the nitrogenous waste and some amount of water is present in the ureter. Okay, so ureter is one pair. And what is the function of ureter? Ureter carries urine. Okay? Now this both ureters, they commonly open into a muscular bag-like structure, which is a urinary bladder. So urinary bladder stores the urine temporarily and it opens into the opening, which is a urethra. Okay? Through the urethra, we will pass out our urine and this process is known as maturation. Okay? And you can see here the blue one, this is what? This is renal vein. Okay, this carries the deoxygenated blood. And this you can see here in the red, this is the renal artery, which carries the oxygenated blood. And they are receiving oxygenated blood from your major blood vessel, that is your aorta. Yes? Now, if I talk about the external structure of kidney and where the kidney is exactly present. So whenever somebody have a kidney pain and during the time of, if they have a calculi like condition, if they have a kidney stone, so they generally put their hand on a backside. Okay. So we know that kidney is present at the dorsal abdominal wall. Okay. Just assume this is the dorsal side of a body and this is a ventral side of the body. Okay, this is the dorsal side of the body and this is the ventral abdominal wall. This is ventral abdominal wall and this is dorsal abdominal wall. Clear? So from the dorsal abdominal wall, kidney is fused. Okay, kidney is present like this. Now, where the kidney is exactly present? Kidney is present starts from the last T12 vertebra to the L3 vertebra. Okay, we have a vertebral column which is present at the dorsal side of our body. This vertebral column is made up by the small vertebrae. Okay, we have cervix, we have thoracic vertebrae, we have lumbar, sacrum, and the coccyx. Okay, so total how many thoracic vertebrae we have? We have 12. Okay. So kidney starts from the suppose this is your T12 vertebrae. Okay, so between the T12 vertebrae to the third lumbar of vertebrae, this is the third lumbar vertebrae. So kidney present between T12 to the third lumbar vertebrae. Okay, and on the kidney there is a floating ribs. Okay, so floating ribs float over the kidney. Which pair of ribs float over the kidney? 11th and 12th pair of ribs float over the kidney and provides protection. Okay, 11th and 12th pair of ribs, they are known as the floating ribs because they float over the kidney and provides protection. So first point, kidney is present at the dorsal abdominal wall, okay? And kidney, where it is exactly present between T12 to the third lumbar vertebrae, okay? Over the kidney, there is a floating ribs 11th and 12th, which provides protection. And the second is, kidney is known as the retroperitoneal organ. Kidney is known as the retroperitoneal organ. Retro means dorsal. Retro means dorsal. See, every organ, whatever the organ you have, they are covered by the peritoneum. But here, one side of kidney is fused with the dorsal side. So here, only one side, peritoneum layer is present. That's why it is known as retroperitoneum layer. This is what? There is the peritoneum. So why we call them as a retroperitoneal organ? Because peritoneum present at one side only, okay? So these are the points about the kidney. The next, kidney is covered by how many things? How many layers? So kidney basically, it is covered by the layers. So the first, just assume this is your bean shaped kidney. Okay? So this is your kidney, and kidney is protected by the layer, okay? The outer layer of a kidney is renal fascia, okay? The outermost layer of a kidney is renal fascia. Just assume this is the outermost layer, and this outermost layer is what? This outermost layer is the renal fascia. Renal fascia, it is the outermost layer in kidney, and it is made up of connective tissue, okay? It is made up of connective tissue. Next, what is the function of this renal fascia? This is the one which anchors to the abdominal wall. This renal fascia fuses with the abdominal wall. This anchors to the abdominal wall. The next layer in kidney, there is a layer of a fat, okay? The next layer in a kidney, suppose this is a layer of a fat. So this is a layer of a adipose. This is a adipose layer, which is a fatty layer, contains fat. What is the function of this adipose layer? It provides protection. It acts as a shock absorption. If somebody have an external injury, so not in every injury their organ is going to be damaged. Why? Because there is a layer of a fat which acts as a shock absorption. Okay, it contains fat, and what is the function of this layer? It acts as a shock absorption. Now the innermost layer in kidney, that is the renal capsule. Okay, the innermost layer in a kidney, which is this is our renal capsule. This is the renal capsule. What is the function of renal capsule? It provides shape to kidney. Okay, it provides shape to the kidney, and this is also made up of the connective tissue. Now here you can see a concave like structure. This is known as the hilum, okay? Through the hilum, your ureters are emerged, okay? Through the hilums, here ureters are emerged, which carries what? Which carries the urine, okay? In next session, we will going to talk about the kidney function, and also we will going to discuss about the how nephron is responsible for the filtration of blood. Thank you.